Hello and welcome to the session. My name is Mansi and I'm going to help you with the following question. The question says, verify the following. Minus 1, 2, 1, 1, minus 2, 5 and 4, minus 7, 8 and 2, minus 3, 4 are the vertices of a parallelogram. So let us start with the solution to this question. Now here we use a very important property of parallelogram, that opposite sides of a parallelogram, they are equal but its diagonals are not equal. So using this property, let us find out the solution to this question. Let the point A be minus 1, 2, 1. The point B be 1, minus 2, 5. The point C be 4, minus 7, 8. And the point D be 2, minus 3, 4. Let these be the four given points. Now applying the formula that says that if a point P, x1, y1, z1 and a point Q, x2, y2, z2 are two points, then the distance between them is given by square root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square plus z2 minus z1 the whole square. So using this, let us find out the distance between the point A and B. So AB is equal to square root of 1 minus minus 1 the whole square plus minus 2 minus 2 the whole square plus 5 minus 1 the whole square. This is equal to square root of, now 1 minus minus 1 is 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1 is 2 and square of 2 is 4, plus minus 2 is minus 4 and square of minus 4 is 16, 5 minus 1 is 4 and square of 4 is again 16. So this is equal to square root of 36, that is equal to 6. Similarly, we find out the distance between the point B and C. So BC will be equal to square root of 4 minus 1 the whole square plus minus 7 minus of minus 2 is minus 7 plus 2, that is minus 5, and square of minus 5 we have here, plus 8 minus 5 the whole square is 3 square. This is equal to square root of 3 square is 9, minus 5 square is 25 plus 9, that is equal to square root of 43. Similarly, we find out the distance BA. First of all, we find out CA or CD. CD is equal to square root of 2 minus 4 the whole square plus minus 3 minus minus 7 the whole square plus 4 minus 8 the whole square, that is equal to square of minus 2 is 4 plus minus 3 plus 7 is 4 and square of 4 is 16. 4 minus 8 is minus 4 and square of minus 4 is again 16, that is equal to square root of 36, that is equal to 6. Finally, we find out the distance between the point A and D. So AD is equal to the square root of 2 minus minus 1 is 2 plus 1 the whole square plus minus 3 minus 2 the whole square plus 4 minus 1 the whole square, that is equal to square root of 2 plus 1 is 3, square of 3 is 9, plus minus 3 minus 2 is minus 5, and square of minus 5 is 25, plus 4 minus 1 is 3, and square of 3 is 9. So we have square root of 9 plus 25 plus 9, that is equal to square root of 43. Let this be the parallelogram ABCD. Now we have AB is equal to 6 units, BC is root 43 units, CD is 6 units and AD is root 43 units. Now we see that opposite sides of this parallelogram are equal because AB is equal to CD and BC is equal to AD. So it is either a rectangle or it is a parallelogram. Now we find out AC, that is this diagonal, and we find out BD, that is this diagonal. So AC is the distance between points A and C. So AC will be equal to square root of 4 minus minus 1 the whole square plus minus 7 minus 2 the whole square plus 8 minus 1 the whole square. This is equal to 4 plus 1 the whole square is 5 square, that is 25, plus minus 7 minus 2 is minus 9, and square of minus 9 is 81, plus 8 minus 1 is 7, and square of 7 is 49. Under the square root, this is equal to square root of 155, and we also see that BD is equal to square root of 2 minus 1 the whole square plus minus 3 minus of minus 2 is minus 3 plus 2 the whole square plus 4 minus 5 the whole square, that is equal to square root of 1 square is 1 plus minus 1 square is 1 plus minus 1 square is again 1, that is equal to square root of 3. So we see that diagonal AC is not equal to diagonal BD. This diagonal is not equal to this diagonal, therefore ABCD is a parallelogram. So first of all, by proving that opposite sides are equal, we show that this is either a parallelogram or a rectangle. But we know that in a rectangle, the diagonals are of equal length. But since here we have proved that diagonals are not equal to each other, therefore we can say that ABCD is a parallelogram. So this was what we were supposed to prove in this question. I hope that you understood the question and enjoyed the session. Have a good day.